ACC Panic Room. Jovis, Lauren Brownlow. Who runs New York? Tobacco Road runs New York.
That's right.
I don't think StubHub ticket prices are going to be $6 for Duke and Carolina, 7 o'clock in the semifinals here at Barclays. Wouldn't you think?
I would hope not, but I mean, if it was today, considering some of the matchups we had, then who knows?
Hey, look, the crowds have actually been great, ticket prices aside. The Duke-Louisville game earlier today had all the energy, had just about everything, including a Grayson Allen moment, which I thought changed the demeanor of the game. Grayson Allen got Louisville a little discombobulated by drawing fouls, a bench warning, another foul on a three. Duke got so much energy, they responded, and it changed the course of the game, in my opinion.
Yeah, I think it made Louisville lose their poise. I thought Duke was ready to go home. Like, Duke was ready to take the L and go home. Let's get some rest. Okay, whatever. We're down by 12. Defense is hard. Okay. but then you pissed them off. And I don't understand it. I will never understand it. And then also, I think they were, and Kay touched on this a little bit after the game, they were kind of pressing to sort of, you know, get the knockout punch on Duke, which I kind of get too, but
it makes sense.
You know, Duke adjusted a little bit. They adjusted their defense as well to go zone and expend less energy on that end. Because he said he even admitted our zone wasn't that good. They missed some shots, but it sort of changed the tempo for us because they just couldn't stop them.
Yeah, I also thought it was a really nice tribute of Mike Krzyzewski to run zone while Jim Boeheim went home. The only thing that was missing was Coach K picking his nose on the sideline. That really would have sent it all home. Speaking of knocking Duke out, you could knock Duke out if you make your free throws. I know Rick Pitino was a little salty about the officiating after the game, but hey, look, you went 26 times to the line, and they didn't make half of them, I think.
He was more upset about two of Donovan Mitchell's fouls, actually.
Okay.
He was quite specific about that.
Gotcha.
I hope it wasn't the fourth, because I saw people complaining about that, and that one definitely seemed like a foul to me, but whatever. We're quibbling at this point. he was like, sometimes it's been to our benefit, sometimes it hasn't, but, you know, they can have a big impact on a game, and I was like, oh, God, here we go. But he also said that they were not, you know, they weren't mentally tough, and they weren't. And that was, honestly, that was the biggest difference in the game. You give credit to Duke because they were, and they responded well to that moment in the game and the energy. But Louisville fell apart, too. Like, both things can be true, and both things kind of were.
Now, I know you're going to have Duke and Carolina in your GIF previews, but I am curious. We'll close on this. Grayson Allen back? He's been in the sunken place for like a month.
I thought he couldn't walk or something.
I
thought that's what they said a week ago.
Krzyzewski kind of talked about him getting Grayson going again. And I don't know if that meant what we got in this game.
Yeah.
But the thing is about Duke is that you've had moments where you think Duke is back.
Yeah.
But then they go through their quote-unquote slump, losing tight games. And then earlier today, it looked like you said they wanted to go home.
They were ready to get some rest.
So I can't... Sometimes it's okay to say you don't know what you're getting out of a
team. Yeah, I said that before the Carolina-Miami game. I didn't know which Miami team I was going to see.
So I don't know what game we're going to get out of Duke in the contest against Carolina.
Adrenaline's a powerful thing.
Which is also complicated by the fact with Duke and Carolina games, you never really know what you're going to get anyway.
You really don't. No. I think it'll be a good game. Can I say that?
Oh, yes. It'll definitely be a good game, and we can't wait for it. And we'll be in the panic room again Friday night, prime time, in the Barclays Bunker. ACC Panic Room. See you then. Thank you.